Hello, fellow pen lovers and stationery enthusiasts. It's Christy here, Snarky Wordsworth over on Instagram and Reddit. And today, I want to talk a little bit about how I fight planner fatigue. So I am generally a one planner system girl. I am in a Hobonichi Weeks. I have been since 2016. I look back through my archives. And I know that I love this system. This is how I work best. This is how my mind organizes itself the best, how I do memory planning, and it's just the system that works for me. That said, every single September, October, these amazing haul videos start coming out. And, you know, I just did a haul video of planner stuff myself. So, like, this is not a new idea for me at all. But even though I know I love the Hobonichi Weeks, when I see some of these new systems with beautiful, elegant covers or different kinds of paper, different kinds of layouts, there's this little voice that niggles at the back of my head and is like, maybe that'll be better. And I have listened to that voice for years, and almost every year I order something new. And there's nothing wrong with trying something different. Do not get me wrong. But at the end of the day, inevitably, I would use that new planner for maybe like a week, maybe a month, and then end up back in the Hobonichi Weeks. And it just, over time, became one of those annoying things that I just really wanted to start curbing about my own spending tendencies, right? And even after I was like, I'm not going to get a new system every year just to try something different, that desire to make things feel fresh and new again, even with a new Hobonichi Weeks, was still there. And I would find myself buying like planner cover after planner cover, or new washi paper or washi tape, or all of these other things that I didn't really necessarily need or even want. But it was just that desire for newness that would sort of take over my brain and push me to purchase those things. Now, I'm not doing a low or no buy year by any means. That's not something that would work for me. I am, however, trying to be really mindful about my spending, and it's really changed the way I look at a lot of the things that I consume. I really, really love this cover. I have been in this cover for a year and a half, and it's beautiful. It has patinaed so well. It's from hand stitched leather tea, and I still kind of have that desire for something new. Now, I will say I'm probably going to get another cover as a treat for myself in the beginning of the next year, but there's something very different to me about, like, I need something new, I want it right now, versus I have planned for this, I am picking this up at such and such a date, that way I can treat myself to XYZ, right? I do think that those are two very different things, and that's part of this whole mindful spending project that I've been working on. Anyway, to sort of curb that urge, I have started doing this whole setup refresh kind of thing. And it's not a foreign concept. Tons of other people do it. It's just, this is fairly new to me. And I thought maybe if I talked a little about what I do, it might help someone else with their own process and potentially like being more mindful about your own spending, or potentially just, you know, changing up how you do your setups. So yeah, that's what we are really going to do today. All right, first things first, when I do my setup refresh, I take absolutely everything that I have out of my journal cover. I think I already mentioned this, but this is a trifolio from hand stitched leather tea. I absolutely adore it. It is really beautiful. It has patinaed amazingly well. Like, it is just a wonderful, wonderful cover. And it holds loads and loads of stuff, and all of that stuff we want to take out now. So I usually will have some kind of fountain pen. I have a wide pen loop in this just so that it would fit pretty much any pen. So I take that out, of course. I remove all of the little bits and pieces, and I'll talk about each of those pieces in a moment. Pull everything out of my planner itself. and then I'm just left with the empty case. So this would be the time when, if it was feeling particularly dry, I would condition it. I use Black Rocks. I love Black Rocks. I think it's great. Runiper is also really excellent. I just always have Black Rocks on hand because that's what I use when I rehab vintage coach purses. But yeah, you can see with that folio, you do see that the patina is a little bit different. And even this side, though, is about 4 or 5 shades darker than it was when I first got it. And then you'll see, like, it is definitely a year and a half old. So these markings are from uncoated paper clips, metal paper clips, and I hate these. This is one of the other reasons why I'm hoping to treat myself next year to a new case cover. But it's all just like cosmetic, and it makes it look lived in. I try to tell myself that that's all it is. It just makes itself look lived in and loved. But you know me. In any case, I've gotten everything out of here. Again, if I needed to condition it, I don't right now. It's really nice and buttery still. I would do that. I would also try and remove any stains that were feasible, like if little bits and pieces got caught in the cover, that's when you take care of that. And then you're left with a clean, empty case. So from this point, I'll put in the main cover, and this one, it's the cover on cover with the cat bow and tie fabric material. I pulled all of the pieces out, and I only put it on one side of the folio because I like to have the extra space to put all kinds of junk in the front. So I specifically looked for a cover that would allow for that with sturdy enough leather that's not so floppy as to just be like flipping and flapping around there without having the second cover side of the cover also installed. And then I will install the pieces that go in the Hobonichi Weeks. So I've got my little stencil, and that goes in the front pocket. And this is where things start to get a little bit fun, because it's where the refresh really comes in handy. So I don't know why, but these were just two little die cuts that I had slipped into the front pocket. I'm pretty sure they're from one of my work friends, but I want to swap these out for something else. And in the Hobonichi Weeks, I will also have several like blotter pages that I put in here, and those this last time were this kind of art deco style print, which is beautiful, but you can see like they've done their job, and I want to swap those for something a little bit new, a little bit fresh. So let me get the ones that I decided on. So these are being swapped out for these. I just take scrap paper. I have a ton of scrap paper lying around, and I cut these to 3.5 by 7 inches, and that way they can just basically fit in between the pages that I've written on in fountain pen. And since Tomoe River paper does take a bit to dry, these just act as really nice blotter paper without the extra expensive blotter paper, and they've worked out very, very well for me. And I have this leaf pattern with a little bit of gold embossing. I've got these pumpkins in this sort of like dark academia kind of color scheme, and then these gold embossed pumpkins as well. So I'll just put those in, and then at the back, I just hold them in the back. Of course, I still will be keeping my Aristocats today is. I usually put that in the back because I will always have like extra notes in there. So wherever I am within that back section of notes, that's where that one goes. And then in the back pocket, I usually will have some stickers. Over the summer, I had these super cute little melon themed guys, but I want something a little bit more seasonal. I always have these black cats. These have been in there for forever. So those will stay because I love them. But I'm swapping out like the melon characters for these uber cute Kubo and Lucy autumn stickers, if you can see how adorable those are. And I just thought that would be perfect for when I wanted like pop something in. I'm not a heavy sticker user, but I do occasionally like to pop one in the monthly calendar or even in the weeklies just to add something else of interest visually. So they're the Autumn Cooper and Lucy Dana Ate Oatmeal stickers. And then I always have one of these 6-inch plastic rulers, just because you never know when you're gonna need a ruler. And that's, I think, everything that goes in the very back. So we're gonna flip all the way to the front of my case now. And I almost always have one of these like clear plastic dashboards. Right now I have like the presidents on there because I'm trying to memorize the presidents in chronological order. I don't know why, just for trivia purposes. Anyway, I do have this dashboard and I will always put some kind of sticky note up at the top. And I've been trying to decide between these super cute memory toasts and this like woodsy style sticky note. And I don't know. I mean, it could go either way, right? Because before I had these teeny tiny toasts, which are really, really cute, but again, going for something different, not so different, but much larger or completely other. I'm going to go with the memory toast. So let's go with memory toast. And I only put like 5 to 10 of these on the dashboard because I don't need the whole pack and I can always replenish. So let's just do like, go with 10. Now, if I didn't want to have this chronological order of presidents on here, I could very easily put the other set of post-it notes down there. It's just, like I said, I'm trying to keep this at the forefront of my mind so I can actually succeed in memorizing these. Anyway, these always go in this pocket here. Okay. So I went and I made my own little envelope from paper that I'm already using for those little blotter sheets. So I've got this little envelope and I wanted to be able to put like ephemera in here or, you know, sticker flakes. Like I have these super duper cute mushroom sticker flakes and I think they'd be perfect to periodically pop in. So I'm just going to take a handful of these guys and fling them in here. I also will sometimes just put like die cuts that I want to use in here as well, but that also will go in that pocket. And then I want to get to the decoration for these sides. Like if you recall, I did have these vinyl stickers just sort of paper clipped in to kind of hide this hot mess. And instead of that, I'm going to do something a little bit different. Okay. I have these two photos of my cat Moo, and I want to use them to both decorate and hide the stains. So I'm going to take this, I think you like that. Perfect. I like it. So I just printed these out on my little Canon IV2, but you could very easily just print out whatever photos or pictures you want on your regular inkjet printer. I just had it on hand. In addition to these, I usually will have a washi card shoved in just so that I can always have washi tape. I've already removed the washi tape from this one, obviously. And I've made two. Again, these are from similar papers to the ones I'm using for the blotter sheets. These I did at 2x3, and I just laminated over them, and that makes a washi card. It's really easy and really quite simple. I'm just going to pop those in there. And, oh, I got this super cute little enamel pin magnetic from Kubo and Lucy when I visited them at the San Francisco Pen Show, and I thought that might be a cute little way to also decorate, because it is a very cute pen. There we go. I like it. All right. Now, I also almost always use some sort of magnetic bookmark to keep me in the correct month. And then I just paperclip the current month with the annual sheet that's in there. I use the annual sheet to sort of track health and weight. So yeah, that is my newly refreshed interior of my planner system set up. I mean, it's really, really very, very basic. Like I said, I threw in some new blotter papers, changed out the stickers, cleaned up the cover itself, changed out like my post-its, and made myself a new little envelope to hold ephemera and what have you. But I'm really very happy with this new setup. And that's what always happens when I go through, take the time to cut new things. And it takes me a while. That's the other thing. It does take me like a good chunk of time to decide on a color scheme, on a theme scheme. And you can see, like, look, these are other ones that I had made and been like, oh, I kind of like this. And then ultimately decided against, like, this cute little pumpkin print. Just at the end of the day was not really calling to me. See, like, there's that whole scheme, and then there's this sort of dark academia-y styled theme, and I don't know if maybe it's the extra effort and the time to actually go through those that makes this a lot more fun and more interesting to me and more invested in the final result, but yeah, I don't feel quite the same urge to get a brand new planner system or get a brand new leather cover that I did just before I was working on this whole refresh, you know? And maybe it'll work for you, maybe it won't. It's obviously going to be from person to person, but there's nothing wrong with, you know, changing up inserts, because I think that's really kind of fun. But yeah, I'm not changing out these little dots because they work perfectly with my colors that I really, really like. So I always just slide those in the front, and I will keep this pen. I'm actually refreshing. Leanne Likes always talks about her white Perpanip fountain pen, and I finally ordered a set just because I don't want to wear away all of the color, and I did notice that some of the arrow design was starting to get a little bit faded, so I thought, oh, we'll put this one aside for a little bit. But yeah, so I am going to get a white one. It's already making its way to me as we speak, but that will go in here at the time, and that'll give even more of a little extra refresh, I suppose. But yeah, so at the end of the day, that is what my little planner refresh system tends to be like. Again, it's not necessarily going to keep me from ever buying anything new ever again. It's in fact absolutely not going to do so. I already told you I'm probably going to pick up a new planner cover in the new year, but it does keep me satisfied. And it also helps me to go through stuff that I already have. Like I mentioned, I have an obscene amount of scrapbooking paper for work, for myself, for all of these different projects. And I just accumulate so much. And it's nice to be able to shuffle through. And even if it's just scraps, I can make stuff from it. And it's really nice. And then I have all of these other ones. So if I want to swap out again within the next couple of months, I can. Easy peasy. So, oh, this, I almost forgot. I wanted to put these in the front slip pocket just so I have these cute little kitties. All right, so that was my video on how I happen to fight planner fatigue. You know, if you have any questions about any of my process, or if you have comments about how you fight planner fatigue, definitely want to hear from you. I'm always looking for ways to creatively make things feel fresh without spending a whole lot of extra cash. So any tips in that regard, super welcome. But yeah, if this video was in any way interesting, helpful, useful, whatever, please do consider giving me a thumbs up or potentially even subscribing to the channel. As always, thank you so, so much for watching this video. If you've made it to the end, you are everything that is awesome. Again, thanks so much for watching, and hopefully I will see you next time. Bye-bye.